We have an incredibly interesting moment that is an absolute fear for a lot of entrepreneurs, which is the big incumbents have never been quicker to copy features to not allow startups to gain momentum. And what you see in China and definitely in the US with Facebook and Instagram is now starting to bleed into the B2B environment and clearly into the B2C environment. So we have an era right now where the vulnerability of a land grab of consumers and attention is a difficult one if the incumbent leaders are viewing your business as a feature versus an actual business. Now, to me, that's exactly how it should be. This notion that Facebook should have sat around and let Snapchat grow is laughable. There's never been a time when a competitor goes, oh, that's nice, and had very little cost to compete with it, and they let it happen. This romantic point of view from a creative or a product standpoint will no longer be in play in our ecosystem. So, as you navigate your product and service, you've got to live under the dynamics that the cat is now out of the bag, and that you have to move even quicker to penetrate your market than ever belong. And so we live through an era right now where speed is no question the variable of success. And that's why I'm gonna end with the following. The most important thing for speed for your company and your service is your internal culture. The number one thing that will make your company go fast is continuity and lack of politics, which means we are on the dawn of the era where emotional intelligence is about to become the single most important trade. That skills through technology growth will continue on a daily basis to be commoditized. But your emotional capabilities to interact with others will become a very, very important trade. I highly recommend. How many people here have a company with more than 10 people? Raise your hand. I highly recommend that if you take anything away from my talk, fuck voice, fuck fucking arbitrage, take this one thing away from me. You better go home and audit every single employee you have, and you better figure out which employee makes the other employees miserable. I don't give a shit if it's your number one salesperson, your best fucking developer, or your co-founder. Cancer spreads. With cancer and politics comes lack of speed. Your company will get much slower because people are sitting around debating how miserable they are or worried to have meetings with other individuals. Your company will get slow in a world where the speed of product output, features, and how you interact with your customers has never been greater. So I implore a tech-centric, financial-centric, type A room like this to go home and get really in tune with their fucking feelings. In my company, the number two person is not the CFO or the CEO, a COO, excuse me. The number two person after me is Claude Silver. She is the chief heart officer. She's the head of HR, call it what you want. It is no question the biggest variable to our success. It is never, and I mean ever, been more important for you to care about the internal feelings, culture. Let me tell you how you do not build culture. You do not build culture by having free snacks in your cafeteria. Let me tell you how you do not build culture. You do not build culture by having a foosball table or open seating. You build culture by actually talking to people one by one and understanding what they care about. And what you will learn is some people want money, and some people want time with their family, and some people want title, and some people want creativity, and it is your job. How many people are the CEO of their company? It is your job to know every single one of those things about every single person every single day, because 23-year-old Sally at 27 wants different shit. 31-year-old Charlie at 34 wants different shit. It is time that this ecosystem starts paying attention to the human elements that will drive our businesses to the next level. This is a conversation we are not having, and it is the conversation in the next decade. Thank you.